And a very good morning to you. It is Friday morning, the 15th of October, the year 2021. And this is your friend Angus Buchan with a thought for the day. One of my favorite scriptures in the Bible, Luke chapter 9 and verse 62. But Jesus said to him, "No one, having put his hand to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God." There is no turning back for us. Why do we want to go back to Egypt to eat melons and cucumbers, to have a place to bury our dead? That's what the people of Israel wanted to do when it got tough in the desert. They wanted Moses to take them back to the old places. We cannot possibly plow a straight line if we keep on looking back. You know, the Bible tells us in John 8:36, "If the Son shall make you free, you shall be free indeed." Why do you want to go back to Egypt? We need to press forward. We really need to keep our eyes fixed on heaven, eternity. Years ago, I heard a story of a Muscovy duck, a big, fat, plump Muscovy duck with small little wings. He'd never flown in his life, running up and down that chicken run in all the mud, flapping his little wings, as much food as he wanted to eat. And he looked up in the sky and he heard the cry of a flock of spurwing geese flying in that V formation. No, they weren't fat. They were actually quite lean and thin. They'd had a few holes in their wings by some farmer's shotgun, but they were free. Free indeed. We really need to keep our focus on the goal, the destination. A couple of days ago, I was flown to the Northern Cape. And folks, I want to tell you, I saw something I will never forget as long as I live. No, there weren't hundreds of thousands of people there, but there were farmers and businessmen. There were boys and girls. There were old people. There were policemen there. There were all kinds of people with resilience in their hearts who were destined to finish the race. I have never been so moved in my life. They flew me in an aeroplane, some faithful men, from the farm to the Northern Cape, and then in a helicopter right into the middle of the bush where it has been burnt. There is nothing left, only wind and dust. I tell you what, the people were sitting underneath thorn trees to try and keep out of the sun. This was at 12 o'clock midday. They'd been waiting since 9 o'clock in the morning. When I started preaching, sometimes I couldn't see them for the red dust that was getting blown and the whirlwinds of dust and heat and wind. They never moved. They sat there. I want to tell you, I saw young children, made me cry, come running up to hug me. They were determined that they were going to pray for rain. And we are believing that the rain is on its way. Folks, I saw a 92-year-old man get out of a wheelchair. That's right. And walk with the assistance of two young men to the altar to recommit his life to Christ. I saw something that I will never forget as long as I live. These people are plowing in a straight line. They're not going back to Egypt. No. They're waiting for the rain to come, and it will come because our rainmaker is faithful and true. His name is Jesus. Today, keep your focus on the goal and do not look behind you. God bless you and have a wonderful day. Goodbye.